Hello and welcome back to another video. That's right, it's a new camera angle. You're not just looking at my double chin anymore. I mean, I still have a double chin, but that's not all you're going to be looking at this video. No, that's it. I've gone out, I've spent 25 quid, and now we're ready for the new setup and the new format. Now, we're still going to be doing top fives. That's never going to change, but we're also going to do it for movies. Now, what better movie and what better franchise to start the top five with than Mother Effing Star Wars? I did think I won't swear because technically this is a PG franchise, right? And we don't swear on these videos. No, this is a family-friendly video for a family-friendly franchise, one of the most famous franchises to ever live. Like tonight, I was watching Star Wars again for the first time in a few years, and my flatmate joined me. He's never seen Star Wars. He didn't stay very long, but he still joined me for the start of it. And he knew the characters, he knew like the setup, the plot, he knew what was happening, and he's never seen the movie. And the reason why is because it goes beyond just being a movie. And you can say what you like about the recent Disney output, and we are going to get to the later films as well. We're going to be covering every live action Star Wars movie. But that's the thing, is that this franchise goes beyond that. For people, even people who aren't even like big into cinema, people who don't watch that many movies, everyone knows Star Wars. Now, not everyone's seen Star Wars, but everyone knows Star Wars. Now, usually what I do is I go through the synopsis of the movie. But the thing is that this story's so iconic. It's like, do you need me to tell the synopsis? Do you need me to say it? All right, I'll say it. The Imperial forces, under orders from cruel Darth Vader, hold Princess Leia hostage in their efforts to quell the rebellion against the Galactic Empire. Luke Skywalker and Han Solo, captain of the Millennium Falcon, work together with the companionable droid duo R2-D2 and C-3PO to rescue the beautiful princess, help the Rebel Alliance, and restore freedom and justice to the galaxy. No mention of Obi-Wan Kenobi in that synopsis. Poor Obi-Wan. So, as for my general thoughts, I mean, what's there to say about Star Wars that hasn't been said 1,000 times? Like, I can't add anything new to this conversation. All I can say is this film holds up. It's utterly charming. I always forget how kind of, not childlike it is, because while it is a family-friendly film, you're kind of used to, like, the darker tone of the, not just the later films, but of kind of just franchises in general. I know Marvel's very light-hearted, but it feels epic. It's interesting with Star Wars because, and maybe it's due to the limitations of the time, like, they've got the epic story, that's all there, but there's a real heart and warmth and charm, making up new words now, there's a real, like, charm to this film. Whether it be, like, you know, the transitions and the little star wipes and whatnot, it's interesting. Like, the acting in this movie, it's not all-timer. Like, only one actor throughout all of Star Wars has ever been Oscar nominated. That was Alec Guinness for this movie. Like, you're kind of watching Star Wars, and certain bits are really dated. And the most annoying thing is that on Disney Plus, it's the special editions. Now, I'm not, like, a hater of the special editions. I think some of the effects they add on are quite useful and quite charming. But they also stick out like a sore thumb. There's the one where Han Solo's talking to Jabba, and then there's this really clunky editing of him trying to, like, step over his tail, and it looks horrendous, and it's so distracting. The action, when I say the action holds up, I think the dog pit fighting, you know, the final third act, destroying the Death Star, that holds up really well. Visually, it's really well done, it's frenetic, it's fast-paced, it's really great to watch. The lightsaber duel, on the other hand, not so much. Like, it's still impactful, it's still a nice scene, but yeah, it's, when you think of, like, you can say what you like about the prequels or the sequels, but the lightsaber duel in this movie does leave a lot to be desired. It is still, though, it's Star Wars. Like, every time I go back to it, you kind of get wrapped up in Luke's story. It's a very simple, basic story, but it works. It's charming. It's the hero. It's the princess. it's based on obviously like Flash Gordon, John Carter, like, you know, all these inspirations, all this stuff George Lucas loves that he takes from. And I'll say this, in the last year or so, I've actually seen more of those 80s fantasy ones like Krull and Flash Gordon and whatnot. I think they're truly, truly awful. I really thought they were bad. I know some people are going to love them because they grew up on them. But honestly, what's kind of impressed me more with Star Wars is when you see the other sci-fi and fantasy stuff being made at that time or even after. Like, even though this is kind of cheesy at times and, you know, it is very much for kids. My God, it's night and day. Like, the level of quality, the set design, production design, the visual effects, all of it is so much better than what we get later on. I mean, obviously, what we get 20 years later is just magnificent in terms of visual effects and the way it evolves. But yeah, but compared to what was being made at the time, bravo George Lucas, bravo Star Wars. You hold up. Like, you know, don't get me wrong, you can still poke holes in some of the effects, and like, not all of it holds up, but it holds up well enough. And for a movie that's almost 50 years old, what more can you ask for? Now, we're going to be going through the categories. The famous categories. So, we're going to have best scene, best line, best music cue, and of course, if you've been watching my channel for a bit, top five characters. Now, this isn't going to be top five characters across all of Star Wars. This is just going to be top five characters from this movie. We're going to do it for every Star Wars film, and then at the end of the franchise, by the time we get to Rise of Skywalker, then we're going to tally up the points and see who wins out. So, the first category, though, best scene. Now, there's a few contenders for this. There is a few contenders. We got the two sunset scene. It's a perfect use of just imagery and music. And John Williams' score, by the way, I think that's almost, more than anything, the thing that's held up the best. The music in Star Wars is just out of this world. Like, it's instantly recognisable. It's iconic. There's so many just memorable scores within this film. Usually, like, when you talk about a great score, we're kind of just referring to, like, the main theme. And the main theme alone is obviously one of the most iconic pieces of music ever put to cinema. But there's so many great bits. There's, like, the Imperial March, you've got Princess Leia's theme, you've got the main theme. You just got all these great scores and instrumentals coming in throughout, and it's just great stuff from John Williams. We also have Obi-Wan using the Force on the Stormtroopers when they get to Mos Eisley. These are not the droids you are looking for. And all that stuff is just really great. Like, it's just instantly iconic. You can't not help but love that scene. It's really good. The whole Mos Eisley stuff is excellent. Our introduction to Han Solo. Now, Han shooting first is kind of ruined by the special editions. I don't know if it would have made best scene, but it is one that is hindered, unfortunately, by the special editions. Now, another great one is, of course, just once you get to the second and third acts, you obviously, when you've got the gang building the Death Star, then being pulled in from the tractor beam, them rescuing Princess Leia, and then them in the trash compactor. The trash compactor stuff is excellent. It's tense. I love the set. I love the way it builds. When first you think the issue is just a monster, and then the ante with the walls collapsing. It's just really, really good stuff. Han chasing the stormtroopers. Really, really fun. Well, probably the biggest laugh of the movie. But then, of course, I think the best scene does have to go to the third act. It has to go to the Death Star attack. It's just excellent. It's thrilling. You forget this is a movie made in 1977. It's so compelling. You've got Han Solo coming into the rescue. It's everything you want out of the scene. You've got the use the Force, Luke. And it's just excellent. It's just really fun. It's really well done. The editing in this movie is fantastic. It's so well paced. It's just really, really great stuff. And for me, the best scene has to be the Death Star attack.
I have you not. What?
Yahoo!
Look out!
You're all clear, kid. Now
as for best quote, there's a few. I mean, it's one of those. You kind of just have to give it to May the Force Be With You. It's one of the most iconic lines in the history of cinema. It's something that's been quoted every day across the planet for the last almost 50 years. It's lived on beautifully. It's just one of those all-timer lines that is just... They've even named a day after it. May the Fourth be with you. Because that's just how big Star Wars is. And if you haven't seen Star Wars, then what the hell are you doing? Firstly, I'm kind of spoiling everything in the episode, well, everything in this video. So this wouldn't be the best way. I'd recommend watching it and then coming back. Kind of late in the video to be saying that, but who cares? It's been out since 1977. But someone we will mention, so best line, even though it is obviously just going to be May the Force Be With You. Mos Eisley Spaceport. You will never find a more wretched hive of scum and villainy. I felt a great disturbance in the Force. As if a million voices all cried in terror. And then was suddenly silenced. I had to take a bit of a pause there because I forgot the rest of the line. I had to look down at that. I apologise. I'm no Sir Alec Guinness. And, of course, it's just the winner. It has to be. May the Force be with you. Always.
Hey, Luke. May the Force be with you.
Now, as for best music cue, so this is more just going to be about what's the perfect combination of like scene and music, moment and music. So you've got the two sunsets, the... You've also got the intro and the main theme and obviously the rolling credits, just truly iconic. You've got the Mos Eisley Cantina music. And then the end ceremony music. I mean, there's also bits of music throughout. The score's just unbelievable. It truly is an all-timer score. And it's hard to just pick one. But I think if you are going to pick the best use of music within the film, do you just give it to the opening credits? I mean, it's beyond iconic. I'm going to give it to... The meat of the episode, the bit you're all waiting for. Who are the top five characters in Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope? Alright, so we're going to go from fifth to first. Now, fifth, it was battling it out between two people. It was Princess Leia, or it was Luke Skywalker. Now, of course, there's a lot of iconic characters in the movie. And there's a few I had to leave out. But you're kind of going to work out who they are as we go along. So, fifth, like I say, it's Luke or Leia. Now, I don't think the performances from either are exactly award-worthy in this movie. Like, I think Mark Hamill does get stronger as the movie goes along. I do. I think early on he is kind of weak. He's a little whiny. It's a little like, I've got to go to Tashi Station to pick up some power converters. Terrible impression, I know. Now, Princess Leia, she's like got these really sassy lines, but they're delivered in a way which you just kind of like, okay. I think for this video though, and I think for this film, sorry, Carrie Fisher, I'm going to have to leave you out on this one. Mark Hamill, you're going to get fifth. Like, be grateful for that, because I think if other people had been stronger, you might not even made it. I mean, you still do a solid job leading this movie. You know, Luke Skywalker is one of the most iconic characters of all time. I just don't think the performance is there yet in this movie to really get you higher than fifth. I think other performers and characters just stand out a lot more from this film. So in the battle for third and fourth, it's between C-3PO and Darth Vader. Now, Darth Vader is one of the most iconic movie villains of all time. And I am using the word iconic a lot, but you just kind of have to when you're talking about Star Wars. It just has to be done. And Vader in this movie is menacing. He's memorable. But he isn't the Vader we truly know yet. Like, the connection between him and Luke and Leia is barely even referenced at all in this movie. Like, I think in this movie, I actually think C-3PO stands out better than Vader does. Because I think C-3PO, he steals a lot of the scenes he is in. He's got really funny lines. He elevates a lot of scenes. Like, even if a scene's getting a bit stale, he comes in with a great one-liner, or he comes in just with his personality and the way he just kind of just bounces off everything, the way he reacts to everything that's going on in the scene. He's just really fun. And like a lot of the first act is carried by C-3PO, really. Like the Tatooine stuff early on, it's just him and an R2-D2 in a desert. And C-3PO makes those scenes. He is what elevates that first act until Luke comes into it. And even then, he's stealing the scenes from Luke. And so while Vader's a good menacing villain, he's more of a henchman in this movie. Like, Peter Cushing is kind of the lead villain. And ultimately, yeah, Vader, you're menacing, you're memorable, but you are coming fourth, and you're only coming away with 2 points for this episode. Because if you're unfamiliar with how it works for this, first place gets 5 points, second place gets 4, third gets 3, fourth gets 2, and of course fifth place will then get 1 point. And then at the end of the franchise, we look back and we see who accumulated the most points. Now, C-3PO, you are coming third. Who comes first and who comes second? Now, you've probably figured it out. It's between two. And I am, of course, going to give it to Uncle Owen. Now, number two, I'm going to give this to the man, the myth, the legend, Harrison Ford as Han Solo. Now, kind of like C-3PO, he comes in, he steals his scenes. He's really fun. He's got great back and forth with all the characters. He's a swashbuckling pirate. He's a charmer. He's an icon. He just lights up all of his scenes. He even survives two very botched editing and visual effects choices in the special editions. Like, he's hurt by the hand shooting first edit. And then, of course, him being, like, looped over, like, Jabba's, like, tail. It's just, even that still doesn't stop him from being great and being cool and just being a legend. Like Han Solo, he comes in, he's a man who's just after it out for himself. He just livens up every scene. He gets the biggest laugh of the movie with the Stormtrooper chase. I really like his back and forth with Leia. I really like his cynicism. It meshes really well with Luke's optimism. And that's part of what really makes the dynamic of the group work, is it's the different personalities all gelling together. And that's something that, like, a lot of franchises and a lot of films later would take on that. Most notably, even, like, Guardians of the Galaxy. And he gets his hero moment. He's part of the scene at the end of the ceremony. It's impossible not to love Han Solo. But the character, for me, who goes even higher than Han Solo, the one who truly stands out and wins Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope, that is Sir Alec Guinness as Obi-Wan Kenobi. The only man to ever be Oscar-nominated for a Star Wars film. And for good reason. Right, you could argue maybe a lot of what he's doing is just delivering his lines. He famously hated Star Wars. He took this job for a paycheck. But that still doesn't stop his gravitas just seeping through the screen. Like Charles Dance as Tywin Lannister on Game of Thrones, he'd elevate scenes because he brought gravitas to them. He brought this like Shakespearean quality into his scenes. And so you felt like what you were watching was real. And Alec Guinness brings that to Star Wars. Without Alec Guinness, this could have been like Flash Gordon or Krull in terms of the performances and the characters. He brings a gravitas and elevates the material. I just think he's excellent in this. There's a reason why the franchise goes on to focus on Obi-Wan Kenobi so much with the prequels and even have her own spin-off. You could argue that's also due to the excellence of Ewan McGregor. But the reason why people even care about him in the first place is because Obi-Wan Kenobi, he comes in with the old man, wise mentor role and absolutely kills it. Like, the thing is like I say, he's just delivering a lot of his lines. He's not even, like, trying to give a great performance. It's just effortless for him. He's so great. I love watching him on screen. I love Obi-Wan Kenobi. It's a shame about the fight scene. That did almost dock him a little bit because it's not... His lightsaber moves aren't exactly the best, but you know what? He's an old man. I can live with it. I can forgive it. And he wins the movie. And here it is, the final category. What rating am I giving this movie out of 5? So it's an interesting one with Star Wars because part of me just wants to go 5 out of 5. You're done. Instant. Like, you know, it's one of the most iconic and beloved movies of all time. It spawned a $1 billion franchise and it holds up to this day. I still feel that other, like, movies from this time, like, whether or not you prefer, like, Jaws or, you know, The Godfather, or, like, Close Encounters of the Third Kind, E.T., Raiders of the Lost Ark. There's a lot of other, like, great genre movies. I know Godfather is barely a genre movie. It just came to my head. But it's like my flatmates, because they've not grown up with Star Wars, and I grew up with Star Wars, but I was always a bigger Lord of the Rings fan. Like, if you was to show this movie to my flatmates again, like I said, I showed them a bit of it, like, they wouldn't... Like, my flatmate Simon, he wouldn't call this a 5-star movie. He thinks it's very dated. And that's where the question comes in. It's like, for me, it's not that dated because I grew up with it. And I, even though I obviously grew up with, like, 90s and 2000s movies as well, I've got the nostalgia there. And sometimes is nostalgia just too strong of an emotion where we're not thinking objectively? And if you go in objectively, is this a 5-star movie still? Like, if a movie's so dated that it detracts from the viewing experience for someone watching it for the first time. But then again, you know what? It's subjective. Cinema is subjective. We're never going to agree. When I start doing my Oscar ratings and rankings, most of you will probably disagree with me on where I put what. When I do my when I rank all the Star Wars movies, people are going to disagree with me because ultimately... Everything's subjective. So you know what? For me, this is a 5-star movie. I can watch this movie over again and again and again. I've watched it many times in my life, and I'm sure I'll watch it many more times. It's thrilling. It's a blast. Like, the special editions do hurt it somewhat in terms of just its pure entertainment value and rewatchability because it is distracting. But you know what? It's a movie that's so rewatchable. It overcomes that for me. And ultimately, sometimes that's all you need. You need that dose of nostalgia, that dose of childhood. And it's a perfect blend of just blockbuster entertainment with dated effects. It's got its charms. It's what Flash Gordon could and should have been, but wasn't. And it's just, it's Star Wars. Now, this isn't gonna, like, hold through for all of these movies. I'm going to be a lot more critical on some other Star Wars movies, let's just say. I won't say which ones yet, but as for this one, so despite the detractors, for me, this movie holds up. I love going back to it. It's a 5-star movie. It's one of the most influential movies ever made, and it's Star Wars. So, let me know, what are your thoughts on Star Wars? Who are your top 5 characters for the movie? What's your favourite scene, the best line? Best bit of music. We're going to be doing that for all these films. Let me know.